So another important compound is calcium carbonate, or known as limestone. This calcium carbonate is available as limestone in the earth, and it is also extracted from the earth as a limestone. Okay, and of course, apart from the zinc, it is also prepared from CaOH twice on treatment with the carbonate, MCaCO3. Okay, so this reaction has to be limited with limited carbon dioxide, because if there is excess, the calcium carbonate forms becomes calcium hydrogen carbonate or calcium bicarbonate. So the reaction has to be with the limited carbon dioxide, okay, limited CO2, and they can also be formed from CaCl2 with the CO2 to form CaCO3. Actually, the CaCl2 plus we can have as instead of this thing CaCl2 plus Na2CO3. Give CaCO3 plus NaCl. Okay, so these are the methods of formation, and the calcium carbonate on heating, their properties wise, on heating it becomes calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide, and this is the method used for making quicklime. So okay, this is calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate is also actually it also reacts with water to form calcium hydroxide, and of course it also reacts with the HCl and sulfuric acid. With the HCl it forms calcium chloride plus carbon dioxide plus water and plus H2SO4. It forms calcium sulfate plus carbon dioxide plus water. Okay, so these are the reactions of limestone. So I know limestone is used in definitely for preparation of quicklime along with magnesium carbonate. It is used as a flux in extraction of iron. Okay, it is also used for preparation of cement. It's an important raw material for the preparation of cement. So, and it has a lot of other uses also for calcium carbonate. So other important product is calcium plaster of Paris or calcium sulfate half H2O. Plaster of Paris. So this plaster of Paris is made from CaSO42H2O. This is gypsum. On heating at 393 Kelvin, at heating at this thing, it forms CaSO4 half H2O plus 1.5 H2O. So this is the plaster of Paris. Okay, this plaster of Paris is has a very good property of getting solidified along with the water. This is get it can get solidified along with water to form the CaSO4, which is a very thick, and the substance will not it will be become it become very hard. So this property of plaster of Paris is used in it is used in the building industry for as plasters, and not only as plasters, but also it also is used in especially in orthopedics, wherever there is a bone fracture, to set the bones are set reset to the original level, and then a plaster of Paris application is there, and within a matter of some time, within a matter of few hours, it solidifies and holds the position of the bone so that the bone heals. The fractured bone or the fractured bone heals. All the cracks, other things gets healed. And of course, the plaster of Paris also is used in making some of the used in dentistry. Okay, and it is also used in making molds, especially in dentistry, also for making some of the ornaments. Okay, so this, since it has a property to be get mold at any time, and get, and of course after some time it gets solidified, so whatever the miniature structures can be made with the plaster of Paris, based on which the original structures can be made. So this is about plaster of Paris and calcium carbonate, and these are the important compounds of S block elements, and they too, they are also, then S2 block elements, they are also important compounds of calcium.